Before explaining this comic image, let's start with resistors. What are these small items and why do we use them? Usually, we can regulate the flow of water in a pipe using a tap, but how can we do so for electrons traveling in a wire? Rheostats are used to regulate the speed of fans and other machines. A rheostat is an adjustable electric resistor. You can see these symbols representing a resistor, or the right symbols representing a rheostat. We need an ohmmeter to measure the resistance of a resistor, knowing that the resistor is an unpolarized item. Or we can use a multimeter functioning as an ohmmeter. And this is the symbol used for an ohmmeter. Let's recap the information related to voltage, current, and resistance. The water present in this tank represents the voltage. The water flowing represents the current, and regulating this flow is done by a resistor. What is the relation between voltage, current, and resistance? Depending on Ohm's law, voltage and current are proportional, while resistance and current are inversely proportional. So if we increase the resistance, the flow of current will decrease. To understand the concept of Ohm's law, we set this circuit, a voltage source in series with an ammeter and a resistor. And here we have a voltmeter in parallel with this resistor. Starting with 0 volts, the intensity of the current appears to be 0. Once we increase the voltage, the current appears to be 43 milliamps. Increasing this voltage to 3 volts, the intensity of the current increases. And as you can see, voltage and current are proportional. Dividing the voltage by the current or calculating the slope shows a constant value, which is 35. This value represents the resistance of this resistor. And to find the voltage across any resistor, we multiply the resistance by the intensity of the current. As you can see, in case number 1, the flow rate of water is low, while it's higher in case number 2. So the resistance used in case number 1 is higher than that of case number 2. Let's understand the series grouping of resistors. Usually, if we have resistors in series, we can add them up to find the equivalent of these resistors. In a parallel grouping, to find the equivalent resistance of these resistors, we can use this formula. For a special case of two resistors only, we can use this formula. Now to end up, as you can see, amps, which is the SI unit for current, is pushed by the voltage. So the voltage source represents the pressure for current to flow. And ohm, which is the SI unit for resistance, represents the regulation for this current. Thank you for watching.